Hello, my name is Artur Rahim, and in this video I'm going to talk about Buteyko patents, trademarks and copyrights. Why, just actually yesterday I got a letter from one person. He wrote, I want to become a Buteyko practitioner, and it looks like I need to buy like some patents, you know, in order to teach the Buteyko method. And is it so, like, can you explain it to me? So I wrote him like a very short reply that I wrote that actually there are no valid trademarks, patents, or any official restrictions in order to teach the Buteyko method in the world except Russia. In Russia, there is a trademark on the word Buteyko. So, and that's the situation with the kind of patents, trademarks and copyrights. Now, I want you kind of to explain shortly how it works so that you can understand like what are the differences between these kind of areas and how it can relate to your life, your practice, your health, like whatever you want to know about this area, again, particularly in relation to Buteyko method. So there are kind of these three things. They relate to three different areas. And it's, of course, very important what is where, basically. So let's say we start with first considering patents. Patents are normally given for certain methods or technologies. So you create certain method, certain technique, and then you can patent it so that it's going to last, like normal international practices, for 20 years. There are many patents related to Buteyko method. And some of them dated, of course, to very old times, like to 1960s, as a priority of invention. So you can imagine, of course, like since Dr. Buteyko discovered his method in 1960s, he discovered Buteyko table of health zones, which is also patented. He wrote that there is normal health, and then 7 zones with negative health, 5 zones with like super health, and that was part of the patent. He got a patent of how to increase practicing breathing exercises, increase CO2, a patent on the relationship between carbon dioxide, CO2 levels in alveolar air, and the control pores, how CP relates to control pores. Also kind of a patent discovery. Actually, in Soviet times, there were no patents, no formal patents, because people could not earn money, could not sell the patent like to abroad, to other countries. But people were getting so-called author's certificates, and that was completely mimicking what was going on in the Western world with patents. So the kind of similar system. System again was different because in Soviet times, again, nobody could own the patent. So if you invent something, it was owned by the government, and that was the reason why we would call it author's certificate. So this is what Dr. Buteyko got. And therefore it makes sense like immediately to say, since Dr. Buteyko made all his discoveries, main discoveries, like Buteyko method plus table of health zones in 1960s, like they would be definitely already all expired long ago. And so anybody could use the Buteyko method and all things related to patents. There are certain kind of elements of the Buteyko method, certain additional techniques could be later invented by Dr. Buteyko, and there are such patents as well, including the very last or latest patent of Dr. Buteyko, which actually talks about focusing on your solar plexus, feeling kind of how heat radiates from this place. And that relates actually to some kind of meditation practice, as Dr. Buteyko believed, again, like his latest kind of discovery, according to, if we look at his author certificates or patents. And that was kind of the kind of particular technique only. And again, this technique, if it's patented, has interesting properties, because in health area, first of all, you have to kind of understand that worldwide it's a practice, it's a law, that if there is any patent produced in health area and it's still maybe a valid patent, imagine like somebody made some discovery, even maybe some drug or process or technology or method to improve in health, you actually can use it for your practical use, for your personal use. So it's like a bit interesting exception given in health area. So therefore you can use it on yourself, for example, and probably you can use it on your children as well, regardless if it's patented or valid and so on and so forth. Now, when you're having a practice and you're trying to sell services to other people, that's a different story, because if you use some patented technique and this patent is valid in your country, then you have to buy rights for this patent. And patents, I already mentioned, last for 20 years, and after 20 years they expire. That means anybody can use them for free. So that's about patents. And they created kind of to encourage invention, because if a person creates something, okay, let's give him 20 years so that he can try to kind of include, like kind of to involve other companies, corporations, so that they would use his method or his or her method or technique, and they would pay to him or to her, to the inventor, for creation, but only during 20 years, because it makes sense, like you cannot do it like forever. Let's say like somebody has invented, I don't know, a light bulb or something like kind of which is common, and you pay them forever, that would be like really bad situation, because you just would need, if you want to create a company, and you would need maybe to use hundreds of thousands of patents, and then you would need to pay to owners of all these patents, it would be like insanely complicated. Therefore, in order to move technology and our like world forward, it's only 20 years period given for, again, for the method, technique, technology, and that relates to patents. So that's about patents. And I can contrast it maybe with another thing, which is called copyright. Because copyright can be given, for example, like most commonly, like you probably know, like some, let's say some famous song or symphony or some musical piece created by a composer, by some artist, and you can hear it like on radio, you can see on TV and so on. Then, of course, this kind of type of, or painting, so you can imagine like painting, also piece of art. What is going to happen here? Well, here we have so-called copyrights, and copyrights means that actually owners are going to possess this particular piece of art, usually that, as I described, forever, so that means it would belong to them forever. You have to look exactly at the details, but commonly, of course, that's kind of very, very long lasting period of time, and for use of your composition or your piece of art, you get some royalties. So some people can buy, like you write, let's say, to publish a book, you can write a novel, you can write a roman, create a musical piece, again, you can write an opera, for example, again, you can write a song, very famous song, which can become, again, very famous and so on. But going back to kind of, you see, like, you cannot mix one with another. For example, you can't have a method or technique or technology and say there are copyrights on this, meaning that actually people need to pay royalties forever. Would not make sense. So copy pieces of arts, therefore, we are kind of viewed as maybe a bit of luxury, you know, kind of something which you don't need in your life. But if you like them, you can, like, choose certain music, again, buy certain paintings, copies of paintings as well, like, because they are copyrighted, like even copies of them. And and at the same time, of course, we can expect that you cannot provide a patent for some piece of art. Understand? So if somebody, for example, wrote a song, opera or roman, or some like poetry, so you cannot give a patent for that, meaning that it lasts for 20 years and we need to sell it for 20 years. Because yeah, sometimes it's true, like somebody may create an amazing, many musicians were not known for decades, and later they became extremely famous. So therefore, like somehow again, since we are not kind of necessities of life, these pieces of arts, we are provided with copyrights, and so owners, we keep copyrights, so we can get royalties again many, many decades later. So this is about these two areas. Now there is another area which is called trademarks. And trademarks is given for some kind of, if you create, let's say, a company and you get some special name which was not used before, which was not known for this particular, like in your particular area, then what is going to happen? If you invest in advertisement, if you make this company famous, you know, because you may invest, let's say, millions or billions into promotion and make a new product. It can be, again, like, let's say, Coca-Cola, or you can get, like, Yamaha, you know, like, maybe car, maybe some kind of devices, or maybe it's Nissan, like Mitsubishi car companies, for example, from Japan, or many, many others. So there are, like, thousands and thousands of different trademarks exist. So trademarks, and therefore, like thinking about what was created in Russia in relation to Buteyko method, because again, Buteyko method, so it automatically means it's actually should be only patent can exist because it's method, it says in the word Buteyko method, And therefore, like, to create a trademark on the word Buteyko only, that's like, again, a complete lunacy, as I explained in the previous video when I was talking about who killed Dr. Buteyko, because I believe that this work of creating the trademark, and this trademark, of course, was not accepted in the world, because when we started to research on the world what is going on, we discovered that Buteyko method, first of all, have been used already for many, many years by hundreds and hundreds of people, the websites and the business names and so on. And therefore, like on the West, we simply say we cannot create a trademark because it's already have been used for so long time. And even when created a trademark Buteyko in Russia, we actually may have to understand certain things in relation to how it appeared and what it relates to. So since it relates to Buteyko method again only, teaching the Buteyko method and teaching the Buteyko technique, teaching health to people, that obviously means that it may not to do anything to do with trademarks, because this is the area of patent. So it's method technique which is applied to people in order to improve their health. So it's health related to health services. And therefore, thinking that is it possible to get Buteyko as a trademark? And another factor here is that the Buteyko is again is the name of scientist, is something which is totally out of question, because it's not possible to give, it should not be possible to give a trademark on the name of the scientist. As I explained in the previous video, instead of Buteyko table of health zones, I was talking about that in Russia and around the world we use Mendeleev's table of chemical elements. And this table of chemical elements is again like in schools, in universities, colleges, like millions and millions of people study it and use it for practical applications. And if somebody gets a word Mendeleev as a trademark, let's say relatives of Mendeleev, famous Russian scientists, they get a trademark. So what is going to happen? Like, it's strange, because nobody can use Mendeleev's table of chemical elements. Like, it's a scientific discovery, like how to put kind of information in a simple form, so that kind of to simplify understanding of health. And Mendeleev created similar table in order to understand all these chemical elements that we actually ordered. They have relationship, like by number of electrons and other factors. Therefore, like, of course, nobody in the West would give a trademark Mendeleev or trademark, for example, again, on the name of Isaac Newton. You know, there are Newton's law, for example. Would anybody guess? Let us get a trademark, like relatives of trademark. Sorry, relatives of Isaac Newton. If we try to get a trademark Newton, would we get a trademark? What do you think? For example, free Newton's law, we used in textbooks everywhere. Like, and if a trademark is given, nobody can use these laws. No, there's laws of nature. The same as Mendeleev table of health zones or Buteyko table of health zones. These are laws of nature. So therefore, like, it looks like complete lunacy. And as I explained in the previous video, the only way how it was possible to convince Russian bureaucrats to accept this trademark from Buteyko clinic in Moscow was so that secret agents of KGB, now it's called FSB, we go behind the back to these people who control patent offices and trademark offices in Moscow, and we convince them, we told them, we are very special agents, we know everything about, we can predict the future, we would say, like, it's and so on, and we look like psychics, you know, because we see what everybody is doing. And therefore, what happened, of course, it was very easy for them to convince even again, like, people who kind of create laws to organize this lunacy, to create a trademark on the name Buteyko. Why I call it lunacy? Because it created tremendous harm for the whole Buteyko movement in Russia already for many, many years, because people are divided. People, we had several lawsuits, one Buteyko organization, like, against some practitioners, practitioners against practitioners, all type of mess. So court hearings in order to overturn this trademark. The Buteyko method going actually backwards, I believe, in Russia because of existence of this trademark in Russia. So now going back to organizers, hidden organizers of this trademark Buteyko, are, of course, agents, FSB agents, headed well, he's not head any longer. And hard to say what is his involvement of Vladimir Putin in this area, because it's known, so we of course hide it from everybody, that we use this method. We know about breath retraining, importance of breathing slow and less, and so on. But we steal it from our own people. We steal help from our own people by demoralizing, by creating this huge obstacle in the Buteyko movement in Russia. So that was contribution of Vladimir Putin. I know that he has been fighting mafia successfully. He, like, with criminal groups and so on, amazing kind of achievements. But again, in relation to this particular area, like, it's like interesting situation. Again, it looks like on the one hand, secret agents use it for themselves, and on the other hand, we say to these own people that we cannot use it, because if people who teach it are busy with this type of kind of, you know, arguments, you know, like kind of dirty type of, I would say, yeah, insinuations, very poor relationships, not speaking to each other, like all type of verbal abuse and so on, and of course lawsuits and lawyers and legal proceedings and so on. It's of course like create huge damage to Russian now Buteyko movement, and that's why you can teach Buteyko technique again, as I mentioned, everywhere around the world. Now, what about Buteyko copyrights? That's another area. If there is something which relates to pieces of art or some documents, then of course it can be copyrighted. For example, there is a song about CO2, and some movies actually, some old documentaries, you can see Buteyko was, like, there is a kind of CO2 song, you can probably find its text. If somebody wrote this CO2 song, like about carbon dioxide, it can be copyrighted, so somebody can become owner of this piece of poetry. This is possible. And for example, big book, Buteyko big book, Proceedings of the Second Conference, it's called the Buteyko Method, its application in clinical practice. This is a book, and that legally belongs to Moscow Buteyko Clinic Andrei Novozhilov, so that's also part of the copyright of the book, or pieces of poetry, for example. But when we are again talking about the Buteyko Method, method is the area where belongs to patents, and patents are valid for 20 years. And in relation to Buteyko method, like even patenting the Buteyko method, I worked myself and I wrote myself a couple of patents for myself and studied hundreds of patents, both in Russia and Western as well. And definitely what I know and can tell from what is known about Soviet practice, when Dr. Buteyko created the Buteyko method, it was done in 1960s. And he was hired by the Siberian Academy of Sciences to work there. There could be some other organizations also involved in his work in 1960s. But what is absolutely certain is that any discovery made within this organization by any scientist, research group, and so on, would automatically belong to those who created. That would be, again, Ministry of Health, Siberian Academy of Sciences, this type of organization. So we would be automatically owners of any discovery made in 1960s, and it would be 70s and 80s all the time, until probably, yeah, like probably until about 1990s. So therefore, everything that was discovered there, he was paid for, but discoveries would automatically belong to these organizations, meaning that there would be no way a person can get a patent for something which he discovered while working in Soviet organization, Soviet academic institution, in 60s or even 70s or 80s. So therefore, like, of course, like the whole idea of Buteyko patents and some like patent owners and so on, it's when you read it and when you hear it anywhere on the internet, that means like just people don't understand what we are writing about. Because it's like the area of, it's very clear, it's like a legal area where there are like very strict restrictions, laws, regulations, and so on. So just to write loosely, like there is Buteyko patent. Which patent? But patent on what exactly? Because there are so many components. It's like to say a patent on a TV, for example, or refrigerator. Like, is there a patent on a refrigerator? Well, the refrigerator is made, I don't know, probably with hundreds of patents. And TV could be thousands of patents. A cell phone, I don't know, it could be also hundreds of thousands of patents. So we have to be highly specific and to say Buteyko patent, like it. Two main discoveries again were done in the 1960s. So add 20 years more, and this is how old the patent may last. So it can last if it was truly patented. If it's later, it's free for you to use. That's how technology, how our human society moves forward.